Okay, so what we see is a mass M of 2.95 kilograms is attached to the end of a string, and it's swinging around. Now, they've put this on a mystical, magical, frictionless horizontal surface. So, now, we know the length of the string for this one is that, and the mass slides without friction. If the string can withstand a maximum tension of 93.9 newtons, what is the maximum speed we can have? So, what forces are acting on our object? If we're going to free body diagram our object, here it is.
Gravity?
No, it's a horizontal surface.
Oh,
what's horizontal mean? Like your table. So, just tension force, right? What else? Which way is tension pull? Which way is tension? Which way is the rope pull? Towards the center of the circle. This is your tension force, right? Right? What other forces act on it? Any other forces? Any other force? Yes, no, maybe? Centripetal force. Which way is centripetal point? Towards the center, kind of like the tension force?
So they cancel each other out?
No. Centripetal force is the force that causes it to move in a circle, right? So we know that centripetal force is the force that causes it to move in a circle, right? Now, think back to when we talked about forces. What do you know about net force? What's net force tell us? Total forces on the object, and we use that, and that goes into which formula? Remember Newton's second law? A equals net force divided by mass, right? Newton's second law. Net force is the one that causes the acceleration. You with me? So, centripetal force equals our centripetal acceleration, right? Times mass, right? Guess what? Centripetal force is your net force. Centripetal force is the net force. So in this case, the centripetal force is being provided by the only force that's acting on the ball or the puck or whatever the object is, and that's the tension. So tension is the centripetal force for this problem. Does that make sense? So far, so good. So if we know this is the maximum that can be, do we know its mass? We sure do. You can find the centripetal acceleration, right? Because centripetal acceleration equals, this is the maximum, so we're going to say if we set FC to be 93.3 newtons, and we know M is, Sir Givens, right? And we know M is 2.95 kilograms. What we want is velocity, right? But in order to get that, we need what first? Acceleration. Centripetal acceleration, right? Because what's our formula for centripetal acceleration? AC equals V squared over R, right? And we also then know radius. They give us a radius, right? That's one of our other givens. R equals, where is it? Oh, there it is, 0.55 on this one. Okay, so this is a fairly straightforward circular motion problem. Fairly straightforward circular motion problem. So, right? So what do we get for FC equals, so we want AC. AC is going to equal what? It's going to equal FC divided by M. And our FC is 93.3. divided by our mass of 2.95. So AC is what? 31.627. Go ahead, carry out all the digits you want because that's not our final answer, right? We always want to carry all the digits we want until we get to our final answer. And then we know AC is V squared over R. So we can then divide that by, right? So what do we get for a V? so V for this one is going to be what? 4.17 meters per second. That's not so bad, is it? Alrighty.